McKenna. Coming up next on this week's edition of News Center 16, the school district's roof construction is finally underway, and Sasha Schwartz brings home a gold medal from Taiwan. All that and more coming up next on News Center 16.
You're watching Channel 16 Radnor. Alexis Yester. Kurt Leinbach. Liza Kane. Chris Swisher. And Trevor Algott with sports. This is News Center 16.
A Radnor native arrives home victorious. And leaks will no longer trouble Radnor schools in the upcoming years. Hi, I'm Colleen McKenna, and welcome to this week's edition of News Center 16. We'll have those stories later in the show. But topping the Radnor beat this week, two masked men robbed the Madison Bank in Radnor on Sunday. The robbery took place at approximately 1 p.m. by two men wearing stockings over their heads and handguns tucked into their pants. While one man stood by the door, the other jumped over the counter and emptied out several cash registers containing $9,000 to $10,000. The two men left in a white two-doored car, possibly a Nissan. The car had damage to the passenger side, tinted windows, and a sunroof. The police stated that no one was injured, and the FBI is assisting in the case. Radnor's own Sasha Schwartz took home a gold medal and led his team into third place honors in Taiwan's Mathematical Olympiad. Sasha spent 4 weeks of his summer training for the 9-hour test, which was composed of geometry and number theory problems. 76 countries competed, and Sasha led his team into third place. When interviewed, Sasha commented that he didn't know how well he would do, but he performed as well as he desired. Sasha ranked 12th out of 419 international participants. When Sasha returns to Radnor High School in the fall for his junior year, he will be taking a long-distance college-level calculus class sponsored by the University of Stanford. New roofs are being built on Radnor Township schools. The construction is currently in progress at Wayne Elementary, Radnor Middle School, and Radnor High School. The high school and elementary schools are expected to be complete by the end of summer. The Sulpizio Gym at Radnor Middle School has already been completed. The main building will be finished by the 21st of August, and the district administration's building, which is receiving new shingles and copper gutters, will be done within 2 weeks. The new roofs will provide better protection to the Radnor schools than those previous. Coming up next on this week's edition of News Center 16, Chris Swisher will be in with this week's movie review. Stay tuned. Hi, and welcome back to this week's edition of News Center 16. Chris Wisher's in with this week's movie review. Chris?
Thanks, Colleen. Wag the Dog, starring Robert De Niro, Dustin Hoffman, and Anne Heche, is a highly intelligent political satire that seems frighteningly possible in today's government. It is 11 days before the presidential election, and the never-named and never-shown incumbent has gotten himself into an unfortunate sex scandal. Enter Mr. Fix-It, the president's top-secret spin doctor, as played by a wonderfully confident Robert De Niro. He calls on a famous Hollywood producer to help trick the American people into believing, through artificially created news footage, that the U.S. has gone to war with Albanian nuclear terrorists. It is a successful attempt to divert attention from the allegations of the president's sexual misconduct toward a teenage girl. Wag the Dog will not have you rolling on the floor laughing, because it's simply not that kind of comedy. This is super highbrow fare. Some of the best humor in the film comes from De Niro's sly back-talking and subtle implications of his former spin doctoring jobs, which may or may not include falsification of the Gulf War. This film is just smart. It does not rely on any special effects, but rather the good old-fashioned virtues of a high-class, high-concept storyline, terrific writing and acting. The only real downside is that all the talking, however well-scripted it may be, and the total lack of action make Wag the Dog feel much longer than its 90 minutes. But this film will make you laugh nervously while you fear the powers of your own government and wonder just how realistic is it, really.
The president wonders about the possible Albanian backlash.
Can't have a war without an enemy.
Mm-hmm.
We could have one, but it'd be a very dull war.
How long do we need him here for?
We're done in 11 days.
11 days, John. We need you. You want to write a song for us? Is there going to be a back end on this thing?
What?
Is there going to be a back end on this thing?
What? Back end?
Yeah, you know, percentage, points, money.
Yeah, count on.
Where's the back end coming from?
Lots of cash, John.
Looks like that thing with the yellow ribbons.
The thing with the yellow ribbons?
Yeah, the hostages.
Hostages?
Yeah. They tied the yellow ribbons around everything.
Oh, yeah, but that was a naturally occurring... But that wasn't put up, John.
I give Wag the Dog 3.5 out of 4 stars. Colleen?
Thanks, Chris. Coming up next on this week's edition of News Center 16, Danny Ure will be in with this week's in-depth report. Stay tuned. Hi, and welcome back to this week's edition of News Center 16. Danny Ure is in with this week's in-depth report on domestic abuse.
In recent years, Radnor Township has gained a great reputation for their excellent responses to cases involving harassment and domestic abuse, and they have also led the development of a countywide protocol for dealing with these cases. Township officers say that they have all seen too many tragic homicides associated with domestic abuse to not respond to all cases very seriously.
But in regards to domestic violence, anything that we can corroborate and we can put together right then and there in a timely fashion, we must make the arrest because it's for the protection of all parties.
According to the area's district attorney, these cases have always been around, but now the local police are beginning to respond and thoroughly investigate each case with more regularity.
Now, when we respond, if we have corroborating evidence such as the furniture's overturned, the door smashed out, or we have any sign of injury on anyone, it's an automatic. Without the assault happening in our presence, we have the right of arrest right then and there. And the decision is not the victim's to file the charges. It's our decision, and that's to protect the victim.
It is not only the township who is taking an interest in prosecuting stalkers and other domestic violence offenders. The federal government has taken some huge steps in curbing these crimes, which are now the leading cause of injury to women. With these new domestic violence laws, the police are able to make arrests without a warrant if they feel that there is evidence that a crime took place. As well as laws being made, the government has allotted $1.2 million to combat these crimes. Delaware County has gotten 2 grants thus far and is applying for the third in 1999. So far, these grants have helped the development of emergency housing for victims and their children, as well as the Domestic Abuse Project that includes a 24-hour-a-day hotline, safe housing, and legal staff. Danny Ure, NewsCenter 16.
That wraps it up for this week's edition of NewsCenter 16. Be sure to check out our website at members.aol.com/TV16News. Due to technical maintenance and renovation to our studio, there will be no editions of NewsCenter 16 during the month of August, but we'll be back to a regular schedule in September. From all of us here at NewsCenter 16, Danny Ure, Trevor Allgott, Chris Swisher, Gustavo Godoy, I'm Colleen McKenna. See you in September.